Greetings, everyone. My name is Ettervale, and welcome to my let's try of the demo of Rotwood, a 2D hack and slash dungeon crawler in development by Klei Entertainment. We awaken in this forest clearing. Yeah, what did hit us? It's alright. Let's try rescuing him. Burn out the armorer and Hamish the blacksmith. Toots out there as well. Not if we have anything to say about that. Explain the controls, please. Light attacks with X, heavy attacks with Y. I can start a hunt with a basic skill, B, but I can swap it if I find a better one. And press A to dodge. Prioritize dodging over attacking, unless I want to play it risky. Left bumper to heal with a potion. Into the Rotwoods we go. Get him next time. I'll take this. These bushes are actually thorns. Running shoes or momentum? I want to run faster. Come into the explosion. Nice. Money. Just some extra gloop. Triple kill! Take the core stone. Free sample? Okay. We sure are, Doc. Amphibi, that's what our species is called. Tell you what, I'm gonna hear you out. What propositions do you have in mind? Good to know. I just need 10 more. Greater Yamo, Menace of the Woods. Keep the combo going. Dodge rolled right out of the way. I don't really have any skills that build up based on my combos yet. They're low, and they're dead. I'll take that. Greater Rotwood Forest. Miss. So when enemies are low in health, they start flashing red. Staggered him to death. You're like a smaller version of the mid-boss. You must be a regular Yamo. Ouch. He broke out of my stagger. So, 4 strike. I really like this game's artistic style. Makes sense as this is from the same creator as Don't Starve and Griftlands. Tails. I picked wisely. As it counted as a new ability, I got the better version of it. That's about 8 enemies here. Loop around. Play it safe. pull back. I'll get rid of the ammo soon. First, I gotta get rid of the projectile firing enemies. Walk into the trap, please. I wonder if this game has friendly fire during co-op. Glancing. I can't dodge roll through everything then. One, two, three, four. Every enemy has their own character. I like it. Come on, get a bit closer. Thank you. If only I had something that comboed with electricity. I don't think I'll die during this run, but I'm not gonna chance it. As long as I play it safe and keep my distance, I'm fine. Ah, there's the arcing. Just gotta hit multiple enemies with that for it to work. The armadillo elephant enemies are cute. Okay, so I can actually charge up my heavy attack. Oh yeah, something that builds off of combos. Multi-kill! I always love when that works. If I can max out the shield bar, I'll gain a shield. Like so. Now I just need to collect some damage boosting items. Oh, there goes my shield. Only downside is the shield can only take one hit before it shatters. So that's my special. I've been neglecting to use it for all this time. I'm taking quite a beating. When I get to a low enough health pool, then I'll start using it. Nice. So far, so good. But I haven't found the armorer or blacksmith yet. I mean, they are right. The ladder, please. Is this a permanent upgrade, or does this last only throughout the rest of this run? ...500 HP. Oh yeah, that looks good. This looks like a cool skill. I think all these items only count for the rest of this run. Is that the boss fight? Yeah, that looks like the boss coming up. Mother Threek, rotten heart of the forest. I was warned about them. 15,000 HP. Thank you. That's the right swipe. Now to summon in monsters. Those torns also harm you. Okay. That's not really that scary. Mash, mash, mash. Ah. Broke my guard. That was my fault, though. Due to the nature of this fight, though, it's not that difficult to get it back. Nice. If I get too close, I'll take the damage. Drink up. It appears I don't actually have that many iframes. The entire crew shows up again. I need to deal with you very soon. Clockwise root attack. You can hit me from there. I didn't react to the tail fast enough. Just 670 more. The rot tree has been uprooted. Take the Hearthstone. Expedition complete. It took about 25 minutes, 18 chambers discovered, most damage was dealt by the boss. I could have taken half as much damage if I played more carefully, and paid more attention to details. Hey, dude. You're welcome. I had fun battling through the forest. Sadly, they haven't. Which is a shame, as this entire experience was pretty fun. I can believe that. Pop quiz? It's more important than attacking. And you do it by pressing A. And health restoration's either pretty rare or expensive. Exactly. Weight class, you say? I think I understand enough with the first three items. What is equipment weight? Right. Faster dodge, but shorter invulnerability window. Interesting. And it's good to mix and match if you play co-op. One can be agile, another can be power, and another can be balanced. We sure did. This isn't my first rodeo at hack and slash games. I like how one of the options is it edible? Yeah. Is Tephra the equivalent of corruption? What, do you want us to smash it? Purple glowy rock? Increases my maximum health by 100, and it can be upgraded further. And it's a party-wide buff. Different boss hearthstones will grant different bonuses. There are four primary ones, each likely corresponding to a different stat. Owlitzer. Nocturne Grove? Sure, I'll be right on it. First, however, I want to know more about the people we're trying to rescue. We need new armors and weapons. I'd like to use some faster weaponry, for instance. Heading out. Nocturne Grove. Temp riding. Nice! The demo actually continues on to another area. Based on how long the grove took, I thought that was going to be the lone dungeon of this demo. Upgrades reset at the start of every dungeon. Onions. Ran right into the thorns again. Go for a tougher enemy. Triple tower. Evil onions. Push him back. Ran right into that. See you again. Should have evaded. if I want to play it a bit risky. I can't kill them fast enough, so don't use that strategy. Mid-boss? No, it's a shopkeeper. We found Berna! Not how I expected her to talk. Azuko? Yeah. Potions. Hello again. Can you upgrade our potion capacity? Wart. Thanks, Doc. Hopefully this is a real bona fide potion, and you're not actually ripping me off. Great or Gordo? Gourd big or go home? Oh goody, it's two of them. Ooh, that heals them. I'm gonna focus on the pink one first. Not good. One down. Friendly fire is awesome in this game. Ah, that was bad. I'm currently Agile class, so my invulnerability windows are not that long. Level 2 upgrades from here on out. Hello, Alki. Yeah, we sure are. Tough, right? Yes, please. Oh, That's not a straight upgrade. This one, however, is... This one as well. You're very welcome. Well, all my attacks right now should deal more damage. You. At least you're not as durable as your mid-boss, brethren. Every fifth attack? I really need a health potion now. Thanks, Doc. You're a lifesaver. Things are starting to pick up from this point on. So I can't play as aggressive as I did before. You only do the ground slam once, thankfully. Let me out. I love crits. Bombs away. Can the bombs hurt me, though? They look like the same types of bombs those trees spawn. Big guy? So they must upgrade after a while. Lick. I'm going off the assumption, based on their design, friendly fire is in effect. I would really like to have that emergency revive. Okay. Now I'm tanky. Now my dodge distance is shorter, but my iframes are longer. To the boss. Yeah, this has been an awesome demo. I'm definitely wishlisting this one. Owlitzer, Mother of Darkness. Oh, they're torns. Going to the explosive. Yes. I think Balanced or Agile class would have been better for this. I didn't mean that direction. Some simple dodging. Explode, please. Dodge the torn mines. Alright, that's new. Wait, allies? That's not good. I misread that. I thought they were gonna sweep from the other end. Focus hit power is unlocked. Compared with the mother tree, this fight focuses a lot more on evasion, and because of that, wearing heavy armor is not recommended. And overall, the grove was noticeably tougher than the forest. Dodging in general is a lot more crucial, what with the increased number of environmental challenges and obstacles. New weapon unlocked, the spear. High single target damage and keeping the enemy at bay. Would have been great for the owl. Now we're an intermediate hunter. So increase threat levels. Oh, we're sorry. In short, this demo is awesome. I really like the aesthetics here. All the stage environments are lush, with numerous details, effects, and touches. Everything and everyone has a personality to it, whether that be their animations or writing. Music's pretty good, and the gameplay is rock solid. It's a wonderful blend of hack and slash dungeon crawling with roguelite progression. During each run, I can unlock temporary new skills, and on the meta side, I can unlock various weapons, armors, and stat boosts. And these weapons have their own unique movesets and pluses and minuses. The only thing I wish I could have shown here is co-op. As for these sorts of hack and slash games, multiplayer really enhances the experience. In any case, great job developers. I'm definitely wishlisting this one. I wish the best of luck to you. Well then, thanks for watching, and have a nice day.